If you want to be an expert at managing difficult airways, you need to practice on difficult airways. I'm Paul Baker, I'm an anesthesiologist, and I've devised an instrument that will allow you to do that. The Awesome Bronchoscopy Simulator. It's realistic, it's fun to use, it's very portable, it has a range of difficult airways, and it prepares you for real life scenarios. I've been teaching airway management for a long time, and it occurred to me that people would come to do courses and improve their skills, then they go back to work and they wouldn't necessarily practice those skills, so their skills would drop off. So when it comes to flexible bronchoscopy, I thought it would be great to have a device like the Awesome. Learning a clinical skill like flexible bronchoscopy takes a lot of time and a lot of experience. And normally that would take a long time in the operating room waiting for the right type of patient. So using a simulator, you speed all of that up, it increases the learning curve and it allows expertise to develop much faster. The Awesome is quick and easy to put together, and this can be done in under 5 minutes. You get the simulator out of the hard case, and there are three main parts. You plug in the laptop, you connect the desktop sensor to the laptop with a USB cable, you screw the proxy bronchoscope into the side of the desktop sensor, turn on the computer, wait for the software to load, and away you go. I believe the more realistic your learning experience will be, the easier it will be for you to transition from a simulator to the real clinical environment. A lot of thought has gone into the design of the Awesome. That's why we put huge effort and we've got wonderful graphics. And we're very excited about that. So on the Awesome, you can get into the airway through the mouth, the nose, or a conduit. And once you're in the airway, it goes all the way down to the bottom of the lung. So we include right to the segmental level with 19 segments. We record everything so that when you're doing your scenario, if you want to, you can play it back to your tutor and go over what you've done to improve your learning experience. We can also invert the image because some patients have to sit upright. So you can learn how to do that on a simulator before you have to go and work it out on a patient. Having an Awesome makes a lot of financial sense because it protects your clinical equipment from damage during training. Also, developing expertise means that the trainee, when they are moved on to the clinical equipment, are far less likely to break that equipment. Also, the traditional way of learning was with a tutor in the operating room while the patient was there. So not only is this a lot safer for the patient to learn outside the operating room, it saves operating room time, which is very expensive. The Awesome is light and portable, and this gives it distinct advantages. This means you can easily use it near the operating room, in the classroom, or take it to a simulation center. In fact, I often travel overseas with it, and I put it up in my cabin luggage in the airplane. Being so small and portable, it's easily stored and locked up for security reasons if you want to keep it near the operating room. The design of the desktop sensor was thought out very carefully. We wanted something that was akin to resting your hand on a patient's face, so it's somewhat forgiving. The handpiece, we wanted to be very realistic. It's the right weight, it has buttons and levers that work. So when you're using the Awesome, it's quite straightforward to transfer those skills through to the clinical context. If your specialty is involved in airway management and you want to be an expert, then get an Awesome and start practicing.
Hi folks, Ross here from Open Airway. I'm in the UCT Anesthesia Airway Skills Lab, and I want to go over in this short video the Difficult Airway Society's 2015 guidelines surgical airway technique. Now I'm not going to go into the debate about needle versus surgical cricothyroidotomy. I'm also not going to go into the debate about scalpel finger bougie, scalpel bougie tube. I'm just going to demonstrate the DAS technique on this mannequin. So obviously, we're going to be in a can't intubate, can't oxygenate scenario. We're going to have trial or other options and recognize that we're unable to oxygenate this patient without going to front of neck access. The equipment that I need for this procedure is I'm going to need a scalpel. Dash recommend a size 10 blade, but use what you have immediately at hand. I'm going to need a bougie. You want a coudé-tipped bougie and preferably a hollow core bougie if you've got it, so that you can oxygenate as an intermediate step if necessary. And you want a size 6 standard endotracheal tube immediately at hand. Right, so to perform the technique, we are going to do the laryngeal handshake. Feel the larynx and make sure that we've got the cartilages in our fingers. Feel down in the midline with my finger and identify the thyroid and cricoid cartilages and the cricothyroid membrane. If I cannot feel the cartilages clearly at this stage because of a patient with a thick edematous or fat neck, I'm going to make a vertical incision in the midline and blunt dissect with my fingers until I can feel the cartilages. If I can immediately feel the cartilages, I'm going to make a vertical stab incision through the cricothyroid membrane. Remember that you want to do this vertically so that you have got the wide, broad cartilaginous part of the cricoid behind the tip of the blade. I'm then going to turn the blade sideways. Now at this stage, I like to work with my dominant hand. I'm going to swap hands, and using the tip of the bougie, I'm going to pass it down the trachea, and it should move freely. I can now remove my scalpel to make it safe, confirm that my bougie is moving freely. If I've got a hollow core bougie, I can already oxygenate at this stage. Otherwise, I'm going to connect and railroad my size 6 tube with a slight screwing motion if I have to get it to go in, just until it's into the trachea. Out comes my bougie, and now I can connect and oxygenate the patient and inflate the cuff, etc. So, that is the Difficult Airway Society's 2015 guidelines on performing a surgical cricothyroidotomy.